Welcome to the latest work of mental model series from Safal Niveshak. Imagine that you are given unlimited supply of Dunkin' Donuts. If you don't like donuts, feel free to replace it with your favorite food item. It could be a pizza or chocolate or ice cream or even broccoli. Question is, since there is unlimited supply, how many should you eat? Now let's say you get 10 dunks of satisfaction from eating your first donut. Here, dunk is the unit of measurement of satisfaction. I've just made it up. So how much dunks would you get from your second donut? How about third donut? It's easy to imagine that every additional donut gives you lesser and lesser dunks, right? And there comes a point where you don't want any more donuts. This effect is what economists call as the law of diminishing marginal utility. The satisfaction from every additional unit of consumption, the marginal utility, it goes on decreasing. For that matter, anything that can be consumed by our five senses has this limitation. But there are some exceptions, of course. For example, the flavor of Coca-Cola has been designed in such a manner that it leaves very less aftertaste in the mouth, which means in spite of being sweet in taste, the marginal utility of Coke consumption does not diminish as rapidly as it should. The idea of diminishing marginal utility is seen in all sorts of places, even in income taxes. Income taxes follow a progressive tax rate structure, which means the rate of taxation increases with an increase in income, and the logic is based on the assumption that the rich have lower marginal utility of money as compared to the poor people. Hence, the rich should be taxed higher. Anyway, where do we see this mental model in the world of business and investing? Asking how many donuts you should eat is very similar to asking how many units of goods a manufacturer should produce. That's where the idea of marginal cost comes into picture. Marginal cost is the cost of producing one more unit of a good. So, if a manufacturer wants to make a decision about producing more, it should keep producing unless the marginal revenue from each unit is more than the marginal cost of production. Of course, the assumption is that all the products can be sold. Now, the dynamics of marginal cost works differently for different types of businesses. For a software products business, the marginal cost of an extra piece of end product is close to zero. But for a typical brick and mortar business which sells physical products, the marginal cost of additional product is significant. What about social networks like Facebook or Twitter or LinkedIn? The marginal cost of signing up one more additional member is close to zero, but each new member brings non-zero value to the entire network. In fact, if you think about it, diminishing law of marginal utility appears to portfolio construction also. For an investor, diversification is very important for reducing risk. So if you have all your money invested in a single stock, that's very risky. But the moment you add another stock, the risk comes down significantly. But every additional stock in your portfolio brings down the risk in a diminishing order. In fact, many studies have proved that after about 25 to 30 stocks, any additional stock does not reduce the risk at all in your portfolio. If you found this video useful, you may want to subscribe to Safal Niveshak's newsletter. Safal Niveshak, value investing made simple.